So we're just at the seaside. Sandra's here. We've just walked for quite a way, probably a couple of miles along the seafront from where we're staying in the chalet to this next little coastal town. And just thought we'd pop on and just say hello and show you the sea. I know it's a really weird time of the day, and most people will be asleep, but yeah, I just thought we'd come on. There's not much of a signal either, so I don't even know if this is playing properly or sticking, but yeah, I love how the sun is glistening.
We've got Gypsy Heart Tarot.
Hello, Gypsy Heart.
Sunflower.
Hi, Bee.
As found, Kimberly.
Hi, Kim. I can't. This with the sun being really bright. I can't see the comments on my screen.
Gypsy Heart Tarot is asking, where are you?
We're at the East Coast. We've been here since Monday. It's the last day today. I'm back at work tomorrow, and Sandra's got a train booked from Nottingham tomorrow morning. But yeah, it's just been really nice just to get away and just really relax. We haven't done anything fast-paced or anything like that,
really,
have we?
Relaxing. Chris is here.
Oh, hi Chris, nice to see you. So everybody will want to see Sandra, so give a little.
Hello.
We're just by this little beach bar that's not open, so we get to have some tables. It's really quiet, nothing. Nobody kind of stirs into life until about 11 a.m. which is really nice.
Chris says, have we got our armbands?
Our armbands? I don't know, but it's probably not going to pick up on camera, but our arms are really red. Probably if I took my watch off, you'll see the difference. And indoors, it looks quite
Amanda
bad.
G, Marina, Sean Hall.
Hi, Sean, Amanda and Marina. Nice to see you. I didn't know if anybody would be. I just said to Sandra, because we sat here just really enjoying the warm sea breeze and the sound of the ocean waves and the glistening of the sun. And I was like, wouldn't it be nice just to go live? But I don't know if it will, or one, who will be up. And two, I don't know what the signal is like, because the signal has been really bad. We was able to watch a YouTube video yesterday.
Yeah.
In the chalet, we watched a YouTube video which played. It was Elaine's review of the Mildred Payne Secret Pocket Oracle, and it played perfectly. But if anybody glides us, we get like 3 seconds at a time. But the lovely thing about this coastline is you can walk for miles from coastal town to coastal town in all directions. It's not blocked off. So it's really lovely, and yeah, we've walked for probably a couple of miles along the coast so far, and then we're going to go to there's a huge outdoor market here, so we're going to have a look around that. And there's a fun fair, if you can see over there, there's a fun fair in that direction. We did find a couple of small metaphysical shops yesterday. Sandra bought a tarot deck. I was looking at a vintage universal weight for about £50, but I wasn't. You can't touch anything at the moment because of COVID, unless you commit to buying, and I wasn't going to commit to buying until I knew how vintage it was.
Chris says, haha, no armbands are those things kids put on their arms to help them float while swimming. It was a silly joke.
Oh,
I'm
right.
Still caffeinating.
That's all right. I thought you meant armbands as in like to go on a fun fair. You know, you can put like, oh, that's a wristband now. So I can see B is saying something, but where, but I can't catch it because of the sun. Let's move it over that way a little bit, give you a little bit of a different view.
Where are you, Simon and Sandra?
So we're on the East Coast, a little place called Chapel St. Leonard's. But today we've walked down a couple of miles to a little coastal town called Inglemills.
Selkie's here.
Selkie, hello. How are you, my duck? So how is everybody? I feel really rejuvenated. This has been
definitely
the best thing for a long time. We've all been through quite a challenging few months, haven't we, with lockdowns. Well, challenging year, but you know, with everything I've had going on as well, it's just been nice just to unplug, get away. And as I said in my cup of ketchup and cards on Saturday, you know, I feel recharged whenever I come to the sea. It's just got such magical powers for me in terms of, you know, recharging the old batteries. Is there any other comments that I'm missing? I'm paranoid about missing people's comments.
No, people's just saying, looks amazing, Gypsy Heart Terrace, and I love being by the sea, so therapeutic.
Yeah. Well, yesterday we went to another little town further north up the east coast, and Sandra and I walked right down to the sea edge and found some amazing shells and stones and
treasures from nature.
Yeah. Yeah. Who's the sea goddess? The sea goddess has got
is it Iona?
Iona, I'm not sure. But yeah, lots of little treasures from the sea. And we went to Gibraltar Point. Yeah, Sandra really enjoyed it there. It's very secluded, there's not many people there. You get a beach to yourself, almost like here actually, because it's still quite early. But yeah, it was lovely.
Especially since it's been a long time since I've been to the sea or the beach.
Yeah, how long is it?
Years.
So it's been years for Sandra to see the sea. So as soon as we got here on Monday, because of Tarathon, I got 2 hours sleep. Sandra, about the same, about maybe three. And then we just drove here, and we got here at tea time. But the first thing we did was just unpack our stuff and then come and walk to the seafront and just sit by the sea in the early evening, which was really nice. So even though it looks cloudy, there is some clouds there. It is so warm, and the sun is actually out, as you can see, and it's glistening on the water over there. See if I can zoom in on that.
Amanda G says that she always loves bringing things back from the coast.
Yeah, I've got a lovely shell that I picked up that I'll use.
Kimberly said, have you been for a paddle?
Have I been for a paddle? No. I can't bear cold water on my feet. Sandra has got a bit of a fear of water anyway, so she was even getting a little bit nervous going quite close to it. But yeah, like when I was in Glastonbury last year, there's a little pool you can put your feet into. And for me, it's like being stabbed by 1,000 needles. It's just, my feet are really sensitive, really sensitive. Plus being classed as a diabetic, even though I'm not on meds anymore, you really have to protect your feet. And there's lots of broken shells and stones down by, you know, where the water comes in. And if I was to cut my feet, it could be quite serious, so I'm a little bit cautious. Is it blurry? Is it just the way it's looking on?
No, is this okay?
Is it?
Nerys is here
with you. Nerys, hello. Everybody calls you Nerys, and I've been calling you Nerys, because there was an actor over here called Nerys Hughes, and that's how she pronounced her name. She was in a sitcom in the 70s called The Live of Birds. But everybody calls you Nerys, so I realise I've probably been pronouncing your name wrong for like the last 2 years. So apologies for that. But yeah, so we just thought we'd come on live just for a few minutes, just to say hi to everybody, and yeah, just share the sea view with you and this lovely warm sunny morning. And now we're going to go and explore. After Nerys Hughes? It is quite an unusual name. You're the only other Nerys that I've heard of other than Nerys Hughes. Wow, so either you've got connections with the UK, or perhaps they showed the Live of Birds in New Zealand.
Yeah, Amanda G is saying she loved the Live of Birds. She's showing my age now, and Nerys says, no worries, I answer to both.
That's good. Yeah, I love the Live of Birds too. I can only just remember it. Whatever. No, it was a good sitcom. And it was popular in our house because half of my family is from Liverpool. My dad's side of the family were Scousers from Liverpool. And of course, the Live of Birds is relating to the birds. It's on top of the Live of building in Liverpool. So yeah. So thanks for being here, everybody. It was lovely to connect. Any final comments that I might have missed? Oh, the name of the goddess.
And yeah. B says that Venus is her granddaughter's name.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah.
It's a really nice name.
Kimberly says, have a great day, both.
Thank you. Thanks for being here, everybody. I can't see how to turn it off because I can't see my screen. Where's end? Anyway, do you want to say goodbye? I know. Bye, see you all soon. Oh, this is going to be embarrassing.